are three planets that we describe as being the outer planets. So these three planets are basically known as Uranus, Neptune, and Pluto. So you'll find that actually traditional astrologies do not use these three planets. Traditional astrologers basically do all the way from the Sun all the way to Saturn. For modern astrologers, what happened was in the late 1700s, Uranus was discovered. And then after that, about 100 years later, Neptune was discovered. And around 1930, so you'll find 1930 is actually not that long ago, Pluto was discovered. So these three planets are known as the modern planets. And for us modern astrologers, we've started incorporating these three planets into our interpretations. So generally speaking, these three planets become really crucial for what we call psychological astrology as we practice it today. The planet Uranus describes a chaotic energy and is actually associated with when the concept of freedom and independence first came into human consciousness. In the late 1700s, some of the major events that happened were things like the sort of like official discovery of Australia, the independence declaration in France, and then followed by the one that was in America. So based on these events, you'll find Uranus is associated with that sense of that Hulk, you know, the incredible Hulk explosion kind of energy. So you'll find in psychology, it describes the area of our psyche that requires us to go beyond what is known as limitations or what is like a traditional structure. Neptune was discovered in the 1800s, and that one is associated more with like things like the spiritual, with that boundlessness. And in psychological astrology, Neptune is associated with that part of us that needs this sense of like going into the inner world, imagination, and also the concept of escape. And it's like together with Uranus, it tends to form a bit of that new age understanding. This is also around the time that you find that a lot of people start, it's the Renaissance period where people start thinking about reaching beyond the boundaries of arts and science, and in fact some of the best work from humankind came during the 1800s and perhaps say like the early 1900s. Now Pluto is an interesting one because in 1930, the biggest event that happened around that time, in fact there were two events. One was the Great Depression and the other was the discovery of nuclear energy. Of course, that came a bit later because it came together with Einstein's work. But you'll find that in modern astrology, Pluto is associated with things like crisis, with psychology, with sex, with the idea of that energy that is like how everything seems to converge together and then burst out. You know, it's a repression followed by an outburst. So the thing is, when I describe this in my classes, it's tantamount to having like that nuclear energy suck in and move out. So for Pluto, in psychological astrology, when we look at it, we look at concepts of things like repression, with issues of like ignoring problems that have been there for a very long time, with control, with domination. And so you'll find that as the outer planets that get discovered in human consciousness, we start to find that humans become more multifaceted, and it actually shows in our understanding of astrology as well as for humankind. So now if you're very, very interested in psychological astrology, be sure to check out our website. I am a practicing psychological astrologer, so you'll find quite a lot of articles and other materials associated with psychological astrology. And if you're very interested in learning how to read charts, do check out our website for more information on how to get a course on astrology. Until next time, this is me. Do like our Instagram and Facebook page, and also subscribe to our YouTube channel for more videos like these. Do post your comments if you'd like me to answer any questions about astrology, and I'll address them in my upcoming videos. Thank you very much for watching.